here from the music interview corner, from the Circus Club in Helsinki. The great German band Except is gonna rock this place tonight. But before that, I'm gonna talk to Wolf and Peter.
Hey, how's it going?
Fine.
Very, very cozy here.
Yeah, I'm sitting here.
We're very nice on this little couch.
Yeah, I like it, so close to the rock stars.
Exactly.
Yeah, great that you have time for us, guys.
Thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, and you have a real big fan base here in Finland. And yesterday you played a totally sold-out concert in Tampere. How do you like Finland and the Finnish fans?
Well, we love it. We've been coming here for many, many years, but this is special for us now, having a number one album and having sold-out shows. That is pretty awesome.
Yeah. We should become Finnish. I think we should get a Finnish passport.
Yes, I can give you basic lessons.
Yeah, forget nice. That.
You know the word vittu?
Vittu?
It means fuck.
Oh. Hello, Belgium.
Oh, that's also very good.
Yeah, thank you.
Very good.
Yeah, and in August, as you said, you released your 14th studio album, Blind Rage.
Yeah,
right?
It's amazing. It doesn't really feel like 14 albums. To me, it feels like number three because, you know, when we regrouped 5 years ago, you know, pretty much started counting from zero again, and this feels to me like album number three for some reason.
Cool. And how did you experience the recording process?
It was fun. It was actually quite painless. The recording process went quite fast because we had all the songs very well prepared this time. You know, Peter and I have been songwriting since last May or something, so we spent a good amount of time on these albums, on these songs, getting them ready for the studio, and then we decided we're not going to start recording or even thinking about recording before we're 100% ready. So when the time came, we were ready. It was great. So it was just a matter of actually getting a good performance on tape.
Do you have a favorite song on Blind Rage?
That's tough. I would maybe Dying Breed. Mm-hmm. But it's hard to tell. I really like them all because it's so fresh, it's brand new. So it'll take a while to one or two will crystallize them and become my favorites.
Okay. And you? Do you have a favorite song?
Well, if I have to pick one, how about Final Journey? That seems to go down really well live, and it also got a little bit of a classical piece in there, which, you know, I've been doing for many, many years, but I finally found another, you know, very well-known classical piece by Grieg that works really well in the context of the song. So
your band split three times, and what gave you the motivation to start again at these times?
We just by accident, you know, found Mark Tonillo, to be quite honest. It was just an accident. We were jamming and somebody recommended him, and you know, we looked at each other and realized, you know, we could try one more time with the singer if he wanted to, and that's how the whole idea started. And here we are now, 5 years later, number one.
And coincidence in life. Life is strange like that sometimes, you know. None of this was really planned or well thought out beforehand. It was just totally spontaneous. One day, about 5 years ago, the infamous jam session that started the whole process, and we started making record, going on tour, and, you know, Except was reborn, yeah, and here we are. Crazy.
Yeah. And how did you experience the time without the band?
Oh, it was good too. I mean, we both have our lives and what we do, and we always were involved in music one way or another. So it was just, I think the timing was perfect for us, you know, to find Mark, and then we still have the energy, and we love it more than ever now.
It's a long time ago, but it's cool, so I have to talk about that. In 1988, you did background vocals for the Scorpions on the album Savage Amusement.
Yes, I did, yes. And it was very painful because it was really high background vocals, and you know, the producer really tormented me for like hours. And it's, you know, and yeah, well.
But it was fun while it lasted.
Yeah, so how did you experience working with the Scorpions besides of that torture?
You know, we know them so long. I mean, honestly, you know, we were in the same studio, and they're a nice bunch of guys and a great German band.
Mm-hmm. They've been our heroes for a long time. We practically grew up around the Scorpions. I mean, we saw them so many times in the studio when we were recording. And actually recently, about a year ago, we played together with them here in Helsinki for the very first time ever in our career. It's
was
great.
It in November last year?
Yeah. I think it was, yeah.
Yes, I saw the show. It was great.
Yeah. See? Perfect.
And you did a lot of photographing while
I still do some of it, but I'm so busy now with touring, it gets harder and harder. But yeah, I became a photographer. I put the guitar down for many years and just started a whole nother life as a photographer. Because I've always loved photography, but, you know, music is still my ambition number one. But, you know, I couldn't do any, or didn't want to do any music outside of Accept, and I decided I'd try my hand at being a photographer, and I enjoyed it. But then, you know, the opportunity came along to restart this band with Mark, and I dropped everything, and now we're doing this.
In 1997, you published a solo album, Classical.
That's right,
With classic music songs as rock versions.
That's right. Yeah, I did. I like that very much. I mean, I've always done that, even in Accept, you know, starting with, in 86, I think, Metal Heart. That was the first time we ever did that, and then tried it on occasion here and there again, but I've never really done a full album. So, and that was sort of a labor of love for me. I always wanted to do that, try a complete album with nothing but classical music, but set in the rock genre or metal, you know, with metal instruments. That's a lot of fun.
And you also put a lot of love to the detail into your stage shows. Why is that so important to you?
It's always been important to us from day one. You know, we were one of the first bands who had like the movements going with the triple guitars, and it became our trademark a little bit. And, you know, we want the experience to be the best experience you can have when you come to an Accept concert. So we give everything we have, 110%, and try to tear the stage apart as much as we can with our music.
Yeah, I'm really excited to see you tonight.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, in the past you had some things on stage. You were wearing uniforms, which were decorated with a lot of medals in a kind of exaggerated way, while your lyrics were totally anti-militaristic.
Sure, yeah, that was the times with Russian Roulette and Metal Heart and those years back in the 80s. Yeah, it was just what we did back then. It was fun, you know. It was in a humorous attempt to, you know, make fun of the whole military aspect of things. But, you know, our lyrics were always dealing with that subject in a very serious manner, but on stage it wasn't meant to be all serious. It was just, you know, a look. It was good.
And who had the idea for this crazy conception?
Well, my wife and our manager, Gabby, has a lot of these ideas over the years. She's responsible for a lot of the lyrics, a lot of the album covers, a lot of ideas with it, you know, everything around the band, really, in one way or another way, goes back to her ideas. And, you know, she's really the invisible, silent force behind this band. Sometimes we're just like the puppets on a string, and she's like guiding us from above.
Jedi. Like when you talk Star Wars, she's the Jedi. She puts the force into everything.
Mind controller.
Oh, okay.
Ooh.
But does it also have advantages, or is it an advantage to be married to your own band manager?
Of course it is. Of course it is. It can be a disadvantage too, because you gotta say as she gotta do as she says a lot of times.
24 hours.
Are you jealous because he is the one who is married to the manager?
No.
It's all good. This has been going on for so long. I've known Peter for what? 40 years now. Can you imagine? We've been playing and writing songs together for all these years, so something seems to work here.
Yeah. The only thing I noticed, the couches are getting smaller.
Yeah.
For some reason.
Oh.
People are really saving money. We should have done it over there.
Oh, yeah, but there's a light was not that
good.
Next time.
Okay.
Yeah, and what changed for you over all the years, for you personally, besides the venues, the couches, and the lineup?
I think the attitude a little bit, you know, during the 80s it was more like a lifestyle, and now really we're enjoying being musicians, you know, the trade, the craft of writing these songs, you know, the labor that goes in there and making sure that they really becomes something that people will listen to in 20 years, you know, and we travel, we enjoy traveling much more. I mean, you know, it's a different world, so for us, we see the world totally different now. Back then in the 80s, we went to Russia for the first time. Now we come back and it's like all big hotels, you know, Fifth Avenue type. And that's all over the world. You know, the world changed. We're still in it doing our same thing. It's an interesting aspect.
You know, a lot of things have changed over the years, like how we make records, how we sell records. But one thing that's never really changed is the way the touring business. It's pretty much the exact same thing like it was back then. You know, you take all your stuff with you, you go on a tour bus and set up and five guys have to go on stage at a certain point and see what they're made of, you know. It's not, technology doesn't help you there. You still got to deliver every night on stage or you don't, you know. So you still got to play your instruments and all that stuff. It's pretty much exactly the same as it was back then. So touring really hasn't changed much.
Peter, you just said that you want to make songs that people remember in 20 years.
Sure.
And I have to say that worked already 20 years ago and 40 years ago. Yeah, you are regarded as a pioneer of German heavy metal. How do you feel in this role?
Like a pioneer, probably. Very pioneering.
Oh, cool.
Well, one thing is, it's true. I mean, it always sounds weird when people say that because, I mean, we don't feel like legends or pioneers or any of that stuff, but... One thing is true, I mean, there really wasn't any metal before us. I mean, and we just did our thing and all of a sudden it was called heavy metal and we looked around and all of a sudden all these other bands started doing similar things and a whole wave of German metal was created, but it's literally true, we were the first ones. I mean, and a lot of people always credit us for inventing speed metal because we wrote that song Fast as a Shark, and yeah, I guess there wasn't anybody else doing that before us, but it doesn't make us feel any different. It's a proud accomplishment of ours, but it's, you know, it always sounds weird that people talk about us as legends and all this kind of stuff, you know.
What is the craziest thing that was ever written in your rider?
In my rider? I mean, the stage rider?
Yes. I don't think we
never had any of that crazy M&M crap stuff that you hear about, you know, that no green M&Ms or brown M&Ms. We didn't have any of that. What did we have back in the day?
I've never seen a writer.
Really?
I've never seen one of our writers. I don't know what we had.
Your manager, your wife has it all.
No. She doesn't do that. We have other people who do the tour writer. I don't think that. I think I have to disappoint you. We're fairly normal in that respect. We never did drugs, so none of that stuff was ever in our. I mean, it surely wouldn't be in the writer anyhow, but we're not the party animals, you know. We've always been in this for other reasons, to be honest. Sorry, it's not as exciting as it, you know.
No problem.
Couldn't give you any Motley Crue story or none of that stuff. Sorry, guys.
It's okay, but thank you both for the great interview.
Thank you
and
so much.
All the best for the next 20 years.
Thank you so much.
Goodbye from the Music Interview Corner.